there and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial from Iceflow Studios. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create the X that's on the Mac OS 10.5 Leopard box. I've had a few requests on how to create this, and I'm going to show you in this tutorial. It's actually a pretty simple process. So we're going to start off with a 600 by 600 document. You can make yours any size you want. You can also use any background you want. For this example, I'm just going to be sticking with the Mac OS X theme, and I'm going to be using the Leopard default wallpaper. So to begin, we're going to choose our font and our X. So we're going to go to the horizontal type tool right over here, and at the top for our font, we're going to choose Myriad Pro. Now if you don't have this font, experiment with a few fonts and see which font gives the best result. I'm going to make sure it's bold, and I'm going to make it a nice big size, 700, and make sure the text is black. So I'm going to very simply type out a capital X and position it somewhere in the center of our document. Now we're going to add a few layer styles to really make this look a lot better. We're going to go to Layer, Layer Style, and then Gradient Overlay. It's going to be a very simple gradient. Make sure the angle is set not to 90 degrees, but negative 90 degrees. And the opacity is set to 10%. This will give a nice fade at the bottom, so it's a little bit lighter than the top. So once that's done, we're going to add the outline, the silver outline. We're going to add a stroke, which is going to add an outline on our X, but we don't want a solid colored stroke. We want a gradiented stroke. So instead of where it says fill type, it says color, we're going to change it to gradient. That's going to add a gradient stroke on our X. We're going to change a few things before we actually start editing the actual colors. Under style, we're going to set it to angle, and the angle percentage is going to be 178 degrees. That'll give a really nice edge right in this corner here. Now, depending on the size of your X, that degree might change. So play around with it, and you're basically looking for a nice sharp edge right in there. So to edit the colors, we're going to click on the gradient bar, and we're going to keep the black on the far left. We're going to make a new node right over here. So we're going to click right there, and we're going to make this a nice light color, just like that. And we're going to very simply turn down this one a little bit. So we're going to double click on this and turn it down just so it's not too bright. And then click OK. Click OK and click OK. So right now we have our X with a nice gradient going from black to a little bit faded down at the bottom, and we have a nice outline stroke. But we're missing something. We're missing the reflection at the top of the X, and we're going to create that right now. So to begin, we're going to start by grabbing our pen tool right over here. At the top, make sure that the second button is pushed in, that's the paths button, and we're going to start by defining the shape of our reflection. You may want to put this aside so you can see and compare it to your shape. So I'm going to start somewhere around this area here, click once, click again down here, and drag my mouse downwards to create a nice curve. And once that's done, we're just going to click a few times outside the X to finish our path. So once our path is complete, we're going to right click on the path, click on Make Selection, and enter these settings, 0, and make sure this is checked on, and click OK. So now we have the shape of our reflection, but it's going outside the X. We want it only on the X. Now, to do this, it's a little bit complicated. If you're on a Mac, hold down Command, Option, Shift. If you're on a PC, hold down Control, Alt, and Shift, and click on the X layer right here. And you'll notice that it's confined the selection only to the X. It's gotten rid of all the selection that was outside of the X. Now what we're going to do, we're going to create a new layer, and we're going to fill this layer with white. So holding down Alt or Option, as long as white is your foreground color, press Delete. And that will fill our selection with white, as you can see right here. Now comparing it, it's a little bit off. The opacity should be turned down a little bit, so I'm going to turn the opacity down somewhere around 65. And you'll notice that on this one, it fades a little bit at the top, and we can really quickly deal with that using our eraser tool. Just like that, and like that. Now, obviously, mine's not very accurate. You can spend more time and make it as accurate as you want. But those are the basics of creating the OS X Leopard X that you see on the box and on some of their commercials. I hope to the people who requested that, I hope that helps you. And if you're looking for more tutorials, Photoshop, Dreamweaver, Flash, Illustrator's coming soon, head over to tutcast.com. If you're looking for a Photoshop community with Photoshop contests, head over to photoshoptalent.com. Until next time, this is Howard from Iceflow Studios. Take care.